Hey, Michelle. So this is what I do to create my attendance page for my kiddos. First, I know you had asked where Jenny's cute little buttons came from. So I created my pictures for my classes on the Canva site. So Canva. You just go down to logos are right here, actually. And you can pick a logo and then design it however you want. Blah, blah, blah. So you see, you can just scroll through all these images over here on the left. And then kind of play around with it. You can change fonts, sizes, colors. It's pretty fun. And then once you have a design you want, if you wanted to do this, click the download button over here on the right. And then that saves it into your downloads on your computer. Or if you have the snipping tool option, this little buddy right here, he's one of my faves. I just snipped it. So that's how I got that on mine. Ginny's are way cuter, and there's no surprise with that. Okay, so if I log into my functions class, for example, this is what mine looks like. Mine's not as cute as hers is, but it works. So each day, my students are watching a daily check-in video that I create because I always wanted to be a movie star. So I call it the daily note, so they watch their daily note. I know you didn't need to see that. So that's just a little blurb of me talking about what the day is going to look like. And they have to watch that in order to have access to the attendance question. So when they click on the attendance question, there's my four classes or my three classes for functions. It's just a Google Doc I use the same kind of logo for their attendance question that I did for their class. For today's question, I did the question in the video. So I asked them, why is 6 afraid of 7? Because 7, 8, 9. So they just had to type in 789 and that marks their attendance. Bravon is just writing right now, 789 apparently. He is amazing. So what I do for my kids who are in class, I tell them, I just give them a P for present. They can log in if they want, but this is really mainly for my distance learners. So this is just a Google Doc. Ginny shared it with me, and if you want, I can share it with you. It's a little cumbersome, so for each class, I had to make a copy so I could type their names in, which is fine. But then for each day, you have to make a copy, change the date. So I made sure to clear out all their responses before I made a clean copy. Otherwise, I was stuck deleting all the responses from the previous question. So I just make random stuff up, like, what's your favorite color? What's your favorite season? Like today was, why is 6 afraid of 7? Silliness. In my Algebra 2 class, when they watch their daily note video, I asked them what task 3 was for their question, which was a reminder for them to log on to their online math program so they could do their math assignment for today. So that's what I do. It's pretty straightforward. Oh, so to embed it, I don't know if you need to know that or not. If you need to embed something, I make a page. I used to not make pages. I didn't even really know that was not a thing, but it wouldn't work. And so Jenny figured that out for me because, again, amazing. So just go to page right, la, 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 down there. Make it shareable, copy your link from your Google Doc. And then I just I'm just rambling. So this just says daily attendance, right? So I've got my attendance question. There we go. Sorry, in my head, I couldn't think. And then go to link. And then you just copy and paste your link from your attendance. I'll go back there and grab that. Sorry, I'm all over the place. This video is going to be longer than ever. Where is it at? There we go. So just copy link right there. And then go to your thinger, paste it. And then I just say like third hour attendance and then insert. So it says it right there. So if you have multiple classes, you can just put what hour you want, create it. And then la, 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 la. Loading, loading, loading. There's your attendance question. And then what I also do that I like that Ginny also taught me how to, is I go under options and I make students do these all, complete them in order. So I just click on student completion. And this takes a little while to set up, but it's pretty easy. So you click on this drop-down menu and it has all your tasks there. So the video, they have to view it. The attendance question, when they view it, they just answer it. They watch their video lessons for class, and then for their assignment, they had to make a submission. And then up here, click on must be completed in sequential order. And that way they have to click on the daily note in order to get access to the attendance question. So they can't just go right to their homework without looking at, you know, the directions and you know, important things like that. Oh God, I hope this made sense. I am very like cut and paste, like, I don't even know, very archaic in process. I don't even know if that's the right word. Ginny is super fluent in how to put all this together. So if any of this made sense, awesome. If you have any questions, just email me. And if you want me to share my Google Doc with you, so you can just cut and paste names in there, I can do that pretty easy. It's a pretty easy doc, I think, to create, but I'm not super Google fluent either. So it's my story. Good luck. I hope that made sense. Have a good weekend.